With ProRender, you can render 3D scenes using the power of the GPU. And Release 20 adds some key new features to ProRender, including Subsurface Scattering, Multipass, MotionBlur, and more. You'll need Subsurface Scattering for accurate renders of skin, wax, and many fluids, basically anything that transmits light internally. Here, I'm using SSS to simulate the scattering of light within a gummy bear. ProRender offers a simple UI for defining subsurface scattering. Just choose the scatter color and the depth color, and choose an appropriate scatter depth based on the size of your object. You can enable transparency for a slightly different effect, or use the emission option to simulate materials with a different density, or to simply create an internal glow. You can use a shader to specify the strength of the effect and the scatter color. Here I'm using the Mograph color shader. Support for the Mograph color shader within ProRender is new with R20, and the display color shader is now supported as well. ProRender now offers a number of separate passes that you can use when compositing. In addition to the direct and indirect illumination and emission passes, you can output a number of data passes. The object ID pass outputs a unique color per object, and you can render specific colors for groups of objects by setting the desired color in the compositing tag. There's also a material ID pass, so you can easily isolate areas with each unique material. By default, none of the data passes are anti-aliased, but you can easily enable anti-aliasing on a per-pass basis if it's needed for your workflow. A new shadow catcher option will include shadows in the alpha channel, so you can easily composite objects and their shadows over 2D imagery. ProRender also now supports both linear and subframe motion blur. Just enable motion blur in the render settings and set the shutter speed or angle of your camera. You can use linear motion blur for position, scale, and rotation changes, or subframe to blur motion from deformations. When you use the subframe motion blur, you can lower the iteration count because noise will be minimized as the subframes are blended together. ProRender in R20 allows you to optimize render speed and quality with separate adjustment for ray depth used to calculate the diffuse, glossy, refraction, and shadow areas. You can render multiple iterations with different seed values and blend them together in order to minimize noise. With out-of-core textures, large bitmaps will be streamed on demand to the graphics card, so you're able to render more complex scenes without running out of graphics card RAM. As you can see, ProRender in Release 20 has gotten some great enhancements to make it more feature complete and in some cases faster as well. I encourage you to play around and see what kind of eye candy you can create using ProRender. And make sure to watch our complete Cineversity playlist to learn more about all the great features in Cinema 4D Release 20.